Now there was a set vessel of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar and put it upon hyssop and put it to his mouth. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. Father, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart, God, be acceptable in thy sight. Lord, you are my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
It is finished.
It is finished.
This statement is traditionally called the word of triumph. And it is theologically interpreted as the announcement of the end of the early life of Jesus in anticipation for the resurrection. These last words are seen as a cry of victory and not a cry of despair. Jesus had now completed what he had come to do. Prior to Jesus laying down his life, animal sacrifices provided a temporary atonement for sins. Only through the sacrifice of an animal could people be forgiven and reconciled with God. But Jesus, the Son of God, became the ultimate sacrifice. A plan was fulfilled. A salvation was made possible. A love was shown. Jesus had taken our place. Jesus demonstrated both humanity's brokenness and God's love. Jesus had suffered himself fully to God as a sacrifice on behalf of humanity. As he died, it was finished with the words, "The noblest person who ever walked the face of this planet." God in the flesh breathed his last breath. When Jesus said it is finished, I can imagine he was expressing relief his suffering was over. "It is finished" meant in part, this is finally done. The ultimate sacrifice had finally been paid. Jesus had accomplished a mission. He announced and inaugurated a kingdom of God. He had revealed the love and grace of God. Jesus had embodied that love and grace by dying for the sins of the world. Therefore, opening up a way for all to live under the reign of God. Because Jesus finished his work of salvation, you and I don't need to add to it. In fact, we can. He accomplished what we never could, taking our sins upon himself and giving us his life in return. Jesus finished that for which he had been sent to do, and we are beneficiaries of his unique effort. Because of what Jesus finished, you and I are never finished. We have hope for this life and the next. We know that nothing can separate us from the love of God. One day what God has begun in us, he will also finish. I'm reminded of a song. God is gonna finish everything he started. Even though the waters got to be parted. Lift up your heads. Don't be brokenhearted. God is gonna finish what he started in you. So as Jesus was upon the cross dying, there was a set vessel of vinegar, and a Roman soldier struck a sponge and placed it on a javelin and lifted it up to Jesus' mouth. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he uttered tetelestai, which means it is finished. In other words, my mission here is complete. It is finished. What did Jesus mean by "it is finished"? Jesus gave us many examples throughout the Gospels. In Matthew 5:17, Jesus said, "Think not I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill." St. John 17:4 says, "I have glorified thee on earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do." Tetelestai, it is finished. Everything that was assigned for me up until this point has been done. I healed the woman with the issue of blood. I change water to wine.
Yeah.
I heal the royal official son. I heal the possessed man in Capernaum. I heal the lame man by the pool of Bethesda who had been sick for 38 years on the Sabbath. I heal Peter's mother-in-law. I heal the sick during the evening. I heal the man who was born blind. I heal a centurion servant. I heal a withered hand. I heal a woman with an 18-year infirmity. I raise Jairus' daughter. I also raise Lazarus from the dead. In fact, I even stopped the funeral procession and gave life. It is finished. I taught, I healed, I performed every miracle that my Father had assigned for me to do. It was even in my Father's will, I'd be set up by one of my own homeboys. Someone in my clique or someone down with my squad. For 30 pieces of silver, it was the will of my Father that I be stripped of my own garments and a scarlet robe placed on me. And it was the will of my Father that a crown of plaited thorns be placed on my head. It was the will of my Father that I be mocked, spat upon, and whipped with many stripes. It was the will of my Father that they cast lots and gamble for my clothes by throwing dice. And indeed, it is the will of my Father that I be taken to a place called Golgotha, which is also Calvary. To be nailed to the same cross that I carried on my back to be crucified.
Yes.
My life wasn't taken from me, but I freely laid it down, paying your ransom.
Yes.
So it wasn't the ransom that held, it wasn't the nails that held him to the cross.
Uh-huh.
He could have come down at any time, but our souls would have been lost.
Yes.
Only he was qualified to pay that cost.
Yes. Right.
He freely laid his life down.
Yes.
Everything you could have done to me has already been done. Tetelestai, the worst is now over, and my enemy has done the best for me, the worst for themselves. Tetelestai, I have completed the will of my Father concerning me. Tetelestai, not only has the fat lady sang, but she sung her last song. Tetelestai, because Jesus has finished the work, we are now free. Because he finished, he took the sting out of death. Because he finished, now we could go to the Father ourselves. Because he finished, we no longer are under the law. We are now no longer under the law, but under his grace. Because he finished, we have power to tread upon serpents. Because he finished, we can call upon the name of Jesus and demons tremble. Because he finished, all charges that would have been charged are dropped. Because he finished. Because he finished, I know that my situations are temporary but necessary. Because he finished, I can love my enemies. Because he finished, I am made whole. Because he finished, I know who I am really is. Because he finished, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness.
Yeah.